Okay, so we're gonna look at some of the objectives. This year has been a very good year as far as what we've accomplished, our achievements and so on, but we are gonna look at some of the objectives that we plan to do for 2011, which is a couple sheets back here. James already has it turned up. I'm gonna give the mic back to him.
Oh, no, I was gonna just...
You're not gonna...
You go ahead.
All right. So objectives for Music NWT 2011, this is some of what we're looking at to get done. We are in a position right now to have facilitated Board of Governors training and development session through WCMA to develop our strategic vision and the opportunities for Music NWT. Expanded territorial event support and integration with existing music events, festivals with a focus on membership service, member development and training workshops. This year we are looking for far more money from support for Northern performers, and we hope to be able to help the festivals out a lot more this year than we did last. Expanding partnership development and ventures with some, similar organizations such as NAC, Folk on the Rocks, WOMP and so on. We've been involved with quite a few of them, and we're starting to develop some pretty good partnerships with them, presenting workshops and so on. Development of performers and music industry support organizations database. We have been approached by Government of Northwest Territories to build a database of musicians and recording studios, performance venues and so on, as well as build up a compendium CD and so on, and a list of all the CDs that have been put out by Northern performers. So if that goes ahead, if we manage to get the money from Government Northwest Territories to do that, we'll be looking at that.
What kind of money?
The Acadian funds. We're actually looking somewhere around the $50,000 mark to
really?
Get that.
Wow.
All done, yeah. This is a fairly big undertaking. Since, as James mentioned, we have categories from 2000 to 2004, 2005 to 2010, and then current year. So there's a fair library out there of music that ECE has helped back, and they want something. Nobody has bothered to keep a record of all this. Yes, Dan?
Sorry, a little bit off the topic, but could you clarify what you mean by helping out?
Last year we donated $2,000 to each of five festivals. So Hay River, Fort Smith, Enterprise, Inuvik, here. This year we hope to at least double that and possibly more. That goes directly back to the performers. That's one of the caveats that we put with any support that we give to these festivals, is that it's not to be used for administration or anything else like that. This money goes directly to performers. So it helps pay you to get to Fort Smith or one of the other places and puts money in your pocket.
So it could be used for travel is what you're saying?
A lot of the festivals pay only travel,
yeah.
But they have trouble even meeting that sometimes. So hopefully, you know, they'll be able to give you better travel allowances and so on. Question, yeah?
Back to the database thing, I'm pretty darn good with databases. I'm curious as to, does this have to be sanctioned by any body, or is there any reason why we couldn't build a database, post it somewhere, plug it into the website?
Well, that's the eventual hope, but we might as well take the government's money to do it, right? If we can. I mean, that's one of the things.
So there's not an outlying of expense?
Yeah, there's going to be a fair bit to it, because they're looking for certain things, and we have to follow their guidelines, plus eventually it will become an awards banquet as well, an awards ceremony tied in with that.
Okay.
Is that federal money or territorial?
Territorial.
Is there any federal money available?
Yes.
As well?
Yep. Yeah. We've also we've applied for funding all over the place this year.
Yeah.
We had a very good stroke of luck in that our Cabin Fever Festival actually turned into a two-day event.
Yeah.
It never had before, and. We looked at the number of applications, and James and I actually had decided to pull our bands out of Cabin Fever because we were on the selection committee and we didn't feel, again, that it was fair to be on the selections committee and put our bands forward, so we pulled out. And as I was driving away from James's house, I called him back and I said, find out if Saturday is available as well. And it was. We booked the Saturday, we turned it into a two-day event. And as it happens, for Heritage Canada? Canadian Heritage Funds, you have to have hosted a two-day festival in order to be eligible to get funds from them.
Oh.
So guess what?
Bonus.
We're looking for, what, $50,000?
No, $20,000.
$20,000 from that particular organization. And as luckily as well would have it, that's how it came about. So sometimes there's a little bit of serendipity involved.
Yeah.
Develop marketing and promotion linkages with Northwest Territory Tourism, global tourism organizations, territorial airline magazines, and so on. Develop a logo branded line of apparel. So if you put Music NWT on your apparel, we're looking for something like that, and help to get a cost recovery on that to generate revenue. This isn't clothing, but Y-Click K Glass Recyclers does our glasses for us, and they give us a really good price on them, and we actually make money on every one we sell. Catalog Musicians Accomplishments, funded by Northwest Territory Arts Council, CD products and so on. Development of Northwest Territory's music sampler. If any of you have seen the Yukon sampler, they have a very small CD that's out. They put it out with a package and lists all 10 or 12 different performers on the CD. We're looking to do the similar thing for Northwest Territories. Development of Northwest Territory Musical Achievement Awards Gala, which we talked about. Continue to foster and develop regional chapters of Music NWT throughout Northwest Territories. Recruit and develop regional board reps. James spoke a little bit about that. Develop the Ambassadors of Music NWT promotion program for entertainers performing within and outside the NWT. Utilize accomplished artists such as Pat Braden, Lila Gilday, Digga.
Godson,
definitely. Dana, you're getting out there all over the Canada. So people like you, we're looking for you to help us promote Music NWT, not just in the territories, but right across North America, hopefully. Develop a series of industry-related workshops as requested or required by members with a focus on youth development. We have had one workshop recently. It was well attended, and it was a very interesting workshop. It went over very well. Certainly got a lot of benefit from it myself, and I'm sure everybody that attended really enjoyed it as well. We look to put more and more of those type of workshops on. We've got one coming up called the Licks and Tricks Workshop with Jack DeKaiser. You'll get to sit one-on-one with Jack and learn to play guitar the way he does, all in 10 minutes or less.
Right.
Yeah.
That's true.
Yeah. Develop community-based partnerships throughout the Northwest Territories to facilitate and support membership applications, workshops, and so on. Develop a product service display presentation, so something that we can take out to these festivals and hang up, show what we've done, what we want to do. Establish linkages to Factor, Canada Council for Arts, SOCAN, etc. And membership via through the membership with Western Canadian Music Alliance. Develop phase 3 of Music NWT website. For those of you who've been on the website, it's pretty plain Jane right now. It's a Chevrolet. They assure us before it's finished, it's going to be a Bentley. So keep watching that website. Undertake development and additional funding partnerships with Yellowknife Community Foundation, City of Yellowknife Business Development, and Special Events Grants. So those are some of the things we hope to do in 2011. Hence, we need your fees raised a little bit, which is all good.
Yeah, thanks.
I don't think we need... I've lost myself here. Sorry, folks. So, we're looking for a motion here now to accept our objectives for 2011. Anything from the floor, any discussion from the floor, anything you'd like to see added or that you think is not a benefit? Karen?
I was thinking about this earlier. We're focused on youth. I'm really glad that it's a topic tonight because I think I think there's a lot of younger bands in this town that might be a little intimidated by the whole society and musicians thing, you know what I mean? And if we're really trying to reach out to them, I'm too old. But I think maybe we should appoint someone like as a youth representative that knows the 30 kids that are in punk bands across this town. Because I don't think they even know how to come and ask for help. I don't think they realize what we're doing. So I don't know what our membership is like, but if I think if people put their heads together, there's probably one younger musician that, you know, is a peer to the younger crowd and probably beef up our youth membership that way. Because I think there's so many new young bands in this town right now. Half of them can't even make it into a bar at this point. But I think it's important that we let them know what we can do.
Oh, I agree. And that is one of the things, sorry, my eyes are really bad. I thought you were Karen Singler there for a second.
Compliment.
One of the things that, of course, you're absolutely right that we need somebody to help the youth. And Matthew Bergomo here has a project that is right across the road from us here called ARC. And he's bringing all ages bands, a venue that's open to everybody, and making it very welcoming and easy to play in there. We're also looking at partnering, we've got Todd from the Side Door coming to speak to the members of Music NWT in a way to try and get more involvement with youth band and all ages venues set up there. Not particularly us, but some of our members. Aaron is one that goes out to schools all over the place and speaks to youth and is very engaged with youth bands. And certainly, you know, we hope that Godson, as an ambassador, takes Music NWT with him when he goes to the schools and, you know, brings forth what we can do or what we would like to help do for the youth.
Well, let me have it back. But this is my microphone, so anyway. Any other discussion on the objectives? Yes, Natasha.
I was just wondering if it could be an objective for this year to increase membership involvement in the organization outside of the board of directors. I'd really love to go to meetings. I really would. And I'd love to help out. So I don't know if there's a way that, I don't know, if somebody could even just like let us, is it okay? Like, can members go to meetings?
And members are welcome at every meeting.
I'll ramp on it now as well.
Last year we opened up and elected 15 members for board of directors. After the first meeting of the directors, we never made quorum again with those 15 directors. None of the directors showed up. So getting people involved, yes, we're looking for involvement from our members. We can't even get involvement from the people who took the trouble to stand as directors. So this year I'm going to say, before we hold our nominations for board of directors, if you're not prepared to work, don't stand as a member or as a member of the board. If you do not show up for three meetings consecutively, you will be removed from the board, period. Simple as that. We did so much business as just the executive committee because the people would not come out. So yes, you're welcome at every meeting. And one of the things we hope to do is post those meetings now on our website so it makes it more available to people. Yes.
But I'd like to be involved as a non-board member, just to make that clear. Like, I don't want a long-term commitment, but once in a while, a project comes up that you feel passionate about, you want to get involved, and you want to be a part of it.
Right.
And, I don't know, myself, and I'm sure there are a lot of other people here that like to volunteer their time, but have a tendency to put maybe too much on their plate and burn out once in a while.
Right.
And I'd like to be able to take a step back when that happens, and if I'm on the board, like, I won't be able to, so
correct.
I'd like to just be able to volunteer when I have the time and when I feel passionate about one thing that's on the plate. But usually we don't find out about things until they're already like announced to the public. So yeah, if there's some way that if it's through the website or through emails or whatever, even just like a quick note, just like the AGM that says like, our next meeting's coming up at this place, even if it's like the third Thursday of every month here or something like that in a public place, and every everybody knew and it was regular and people could just show up and be part of it, that would be so cool.
Okay, one of the things that's happened, Natasha, is that we renewed our constant contact recently. Dana was putting out a weekly newsletter where all this information would be sent out to the members. But constant contact fell off. We renewed the option with them, and we've spoken to Dana, and we've now made that a somewhat paid position. He will be starting to put out newsletters again on a weekly basis where all this information will go down to the through the members. Is that correct, Dana?
100%.
All right, so there you have it. Dana's newsletters, when he was sending them out, were great. They contained a lot of information. They kept people up to date on what was going on. So look for them in your email.
But I just want to know when meetings are. Newsletters are awesome.
The meetings will be in the newsletters. It's in two places. It'll be on the news and events in our on our website, and it'll be in the newsletter. We've tried the public meetings, and they do not go well. We've had them here, where there was a big request and said, can you please have a public meeting and have a jam afterwards? We held it. The speakers were on. They can't turn the music off. We couldn't hear to hold the meeting. We had a fairly good attendance for the meeting, and then people just left. The jam was a no-go. So for the most part, if we have the attendance, definitely we'll book a public spot. If we don't have the attendance, I'm not going to book a public spot here like this event and say, close off the pub and everything else, or give us half the pub and only have six people show up. That will be held at a private place like my place or somewhere else like that.
Well, you can still meet at Dapperoma, even if it's six people or whatever, or here or whatever. But anyway, yeah, yep. Sure, that's cool. As long as
certainly.
You know where they are and we're welcome, that's a big thing.
Okay. All right, so I'm looking for a motion now to accept the objectives for 2011. Greg Nastigalowak, seconded by Paulette O'Neill. Got a show of cards, please. Anybody dissenting, object? Any abstaining? Motion is carried.